Good Morning Bay Street is a production of TheUptrend.com and is for information and educational purposes only. The views and opinions expressed in this presentation are those of Stephen Whiteside and should not be considered personal investment advice. Always consult a qualified financial advisor before making any investment decisions. To learn more about the charts featured in this presentation, please visit TheUptrend.com. And now, here is Stephen Whiteside with today's newsletter.
Good morning, Steve Whiteside here with your daily market outlook for Tuesday, February 15th, 2011. In the pre-market this morning at 8 a.m. on the East Coast, stock index futures are basically flat across the board, so not a lot of guidance so far. We do have some economic reports coming out at 8:30 in the U.S., which could add some volatility this morning before the market opens. Just one presentation this morning, not a lot of dramatic changes on Monday. Yesterday at this time, I was getting ready to do my Monday presentations, but I had a personal issue come up and couldn't finish them. But each Monday, we start looking at the weekly charts, and yesterday I wanted to focus on fear and the fact we really haven't had much in the way of market fear in about 6 months now. Last summer, we made a change to our presentations. We took the VIX index and moved it to the front of the U.S. presentation and also started to include it in the Canadian presentation. And what we wanted to do was to keep track of the VIX, which is commonly referred to as the fear index, through that September-October timeframe, which historically is the worst time of the year for the stock market. So we wanted to use this index as a tool to make sure that we had a complete understanding of what was going on in the stock market, because it's one thing to have positive price movement, but if we start to see the VIX or we start to see investors start to move to the VIX, which means they're going to start, instead of being sellers, net sellers of options, which is usually the case. There's usually a lot more options available to buy than investors willing to buy them, because most options do expire worthless. So people are constantly trying to sell options into the market to raise options premium to increase their investing results. What happens is when we start to see the VIX rise, that means investors are a lot more interested in buying options, and they do that to hedge their portfolios. So since the summer high, which was actually the market low, if you look across the bottom of the screen here, you can see that we did not have one single week in which four market consensus indicators turned blue. We did have 1 week here and then a little period here where we saw some blue. Of course, blue for the VIX is negative for the stock market, but we did not see a complete breakout as we had previously done in 2009 and 2010. So as long as the VIX stays in this condition, we have no reason to be fearful of the market, no matter what people on the news or what news events are happening in the world. You basically need to put your fingers in your ears and just ignore the news as much as possible. Now, if we look at who's in control, you can see that the pros gave up control last summer of the VIX. And again, we've seen a general positive trend in the market since that period. We will know to be defensive when we do start to see the VIX start to rise and we do start to see the pros take control. Otherwise, there's no reason to have any fear of the market right now, and that has certainly been the case since last summer. Now, taking a look at the TSX, we're up at resistance here at the 13,750 level, and we're looking for a clean break, and that's a week in which the market opens above 13,750 and closes above 13,750. That is a clean break, and we opened higher yesterday, and let's hope we can continue that for the rest of the week, and then that would take us up to our next price target. Looking downward, this is a weekly chart, so for people who checked their portfolio on a weekly basis and are willing to act, they would see a sell signal on a weekly close below 13,350. If we move a little lower down to the 13,295 level, that would wake up those people that might check their stocks and their portfolios on a weekly basis but are not willing to act. It takes a little bit more to encourage those people to take action than the people that the right side chart monitors. Now, looking at the weekly flypaper channel chart for the TSX, you can see that the flypaper channel is in the 11,800 to 12,300 range. That, of course, is where we would expect to find support. But right now, the market is still moving higher, so we don't have to be too concerned about where the TSX might find support as we start this week. Take a look at some things that are working and not working. Of course, gold, we're seeing buy signals on the daily chart, so we're looking for positive price movement in this sector. We need a weekly close above 396.18 this coming Friday to give us a new weekly buy signal for the gold sector. Utilities rolled over last week. We're seeing still seeing strength in financial services. We're up testing those highs from the 2010 highs. And, you know, people have memories. There's a lot of people that got stuck where they had bought up at those highs, of course, chasing success. And then the market started to break down. They didn't know what to do, so they continued to hold and rode the market all the way down. And now they've ridden the market all the way back up. And what are they going to do? Of course, they're going to sell up here to try to get their money back from 2010. And that could put downward pressure on these stocks. I'm not expecting too much downward pressure between now and the end of the month, considering it's RRSP season. And so there's a lot of money coming into the market right now. Taking a look at what's not working and certainly out of control of the average Canadian RRSP investor is the price of crude oil. It is now on a weekly sell signal. That is also true of coal and natural gas. Gold itself, we're still on a weekly sell signal and we're looking for a move close above 1374.51. If we can close above there, then we're back on a weekly buy signal for the price of gold. Some of the things that are really working right now is uranium is still in a major up move, and we're still seeing a lot of money going to the grain sector, including the price of wheat. And of course, that is supportive for our agricultural stocks, including those fertilizer stocks. Let's take a look at the daily charts, and not a lot of new information to talk about here. Still looking for the VIX to make lower lows, to break down below those previous lows. That still hasn't happened yet. A daily close above 1714 would give us a new buy signal for the VIX, and we would expect that that would be negative for short-term stock prices. Take a look at the TSX, no major changes there. If we can continue to move higher, we're expecting psychological resistance at 14,000, and then our mathematical target is 14,062. Take a look at energy. It's come back. It's now on a buy signal. That also gave us a buy signal for our Horizon Beta Pro Bull ETF. And if you'll remember, we were sitting on our hands and waiting for a buy signal in the bear ETF. That never came through. So we sat on the sidelines. We sold our bull position last week and had been sitting on the sidelines. And now, as of the open this morning, we're now back in the energy sector. Take a look at financial services, no change there. Gold stocks are still on a buy signal right now, no real momentum there. Looking at materials, they're doing much better. Venture exchange is still doing well. No change for copper stocks, but they've been weak over the last few days. Fertilizer stocks continue to move higher. Silver stocks still outpacing gold stocks. No change for uranium. Saw some weakness on Friday, but came back yesterday. Take a look at the Canadian dollar. It's still above par, still finding resistance at 101. If we can break out above 101, 103 is our next target. U.S. dollar is now on a buy signal, no change there. The bonds have moved up over the last couple of days. We need to close above 119.34 to give us a buy signal on Monday. Copper is still on a buy signal, gold is still on a buy signal, and of course silver is certainly outpacing the price of gold right now. A little bit of concern, we're running into an open gap, and we'll have to see if that acts as resistance. Take a look at crude oil, still on a daily downtrend. Close above 88.22 would give us a buy signal, and a close above 423 would give us a buy signal for natural gas. Now, looking, taking a microscope to Tuesday's trading activity, Monday ended with an early warning signal up there. We need a close below 13,700 to tell us that the bears are back in control. A pullback back to that level, we would expect to find support in the hourly flypaper channel and would only be concerned if we started to break down below that. The first sign of weakness on Tuesday is an hourly close below 13,860. Okay, that's all for Tuesday morning, folks. Have a great day. We'll talk to you again on Wednesday morning.